When I was a young social worker back in the 70s, people who were admitted into long-term care homes were driving their cars to go to long-term care. They were really more like what we think of today as seniors assisted living. If you can think back, we had no home care programs, we had no seniors apartments. So the role of long-term care homes was more about social support than medical care. And when people were dying or reaching the end of their lives, they came to the hospital, even from the long-term care homes. So over time, a number of things have changed. One of them is the nature of residents who are going into long-term care. Now we have a lot, and we've worked very hard to have community support programs, seniors assisted living, home care, where people who want to can die at home. So the people going into long-term care homes are very elderly, often 80s, 90s, over 100 years old. They've lived at home until they're very, very frail, have multiple kind of medical needs, often dementia, and you know they really are reaching the end of their lives when they're admitted into long-term care. And about 20% of them die within the first year, and about 40% of them die within the first 2 years. So it's a place where they really need to shift their focus to a palliative approach to care. The challenge has been skilling up, of course, for that role. And most of the workers in long-term care homes are not nurses or registered practical nurses, but frontline personal care workers or personal support workers who don't have a lot of medical training. They're really trained to help with activities of daily living, bathing, dressing, feeding. And now all of a sudden, they need to learn how to take major responsibility for not only the physical care of that resident who is very, very frail and approaching the end of their life, but talking with them, talking with their families who are sitting at the bedside, looking for support, looking for information. So that's a practical issue. Kind of a philosophical challenge for homes is that they've worked really hard to convey to society that they're a place where older people can come to live and they can live with quality of life, they can have meaningful relationships, activities. So it's a real challenge for them to think about, well, this is a place where you come to die, because how does dying and living coexist in the image of long-term care in our society? I think one of the reasons we're moving forward on this is that we're recognizing that with the palliative approach to chronic disease management, which is, I think, the model that fits best in a long-term care setting, living and dying aren't mutually exclusive. And so someone can be benefiting from restorative care in the long-term care home, participating in all kinds of activities, and yet we wouldn't be surprised often if they died within the next year. So there are palliative goals of care. There's the importance of, talking to the residents and the families about, reassuring them that when the time comes, the long-term care home is a place where they can stay, because it is now their home. They can die at home.